guys, good morning. Welcome to another video. Today I'm at Woodhouse Grange Fishery in Hatfield, Doncaster. We're on Ghost Lake and it's part of the Black Diamond Angling Club matches, like previous videos. We're fishing 10 till 4 and we're on match 3. Okay, managed to win the first two matches, so that's a brilliant result. I'm on here today, never fished it before, so like I said before, I'll get my excuses in. I messaged Carl Roberts early in the week and he told me it's caster shaller or pellet shaller. Bought 4 pints of casters. I'm going to fish top 2 and 2, top 2 and 3 with my F1 Daiwa speed kits. Basically starting off about, I'll start on the deck and then work my way up shaller, keep feeding. I have got some 4mm fishery pellets just in case they want to change. And he also said corn, micros and corn down the edge was working well. So that's my plan of attack today. So about 5 minutes before they off, and I'll see you when we get started. Again, bites. There we are, we're into the first fish. Wind's a bit drastic. I like to leave a few casters on my side tray if it hardens them up. Sometimes when you put them in a band, it squashes them if they're soft. So I'm only feeding about between 6 and 8 casters at a time. Feed too many, end up with foul up fish. Got to feed it regular. The amount of F1s in here is unbelievable. I can see one fizzing up top already, so I'm probably too deep there. Keep that bait going in all the time, only little and often. And what will happen is eventually you'll get bites. You'll not be able to hit them. So basically the fishing, the swim hitting the line, pulling the float under. Watching, everybody's on deck a minute, so it's a small enough lake to keep an eye on everybody. Now I'm watching people now and I can see them going down edge straight away, which is good, but they're neglecting the shallow line, so I'm hoping that I can continue to catch fish. This wind's terrible though, but I don't mind it. I want to fish in shorts. So. Yeah, that's better. I wonder if I'm feeding that.
I'm not going to break down, hopefully. It saves me time, makes me more efficient. However, it's a good fish to me. I have to decide whether it'll come up quicker.
Yeah. Shipped in. Not.
I don't think that was too bad. Whoop. Certainly, I'm just going to feed again because I need to. There we are. Yeah, that's two fish. Float wise, they're just some Rizoff floats I bought years ago. When they were 60p on line, but they're only 0.1 and 0.2 of a gram. Line goes through the body of the float, so there we are. Look, that's what we're talking about. I think with this floats you've got, it don't really matter, does it? This wind's not very good for landing net. I've got my landing there, my roller's very high at back of me. It helps me land the fish. Three fish, 20 minutes in. Yes, that's perfect. Keep that bait going in. Two types of F1. There's some that fight like wet paper bags, and there's some fight like the £10. It's always a good sign. Crushed maggots, casters in his mouth. I can live with that. Blinking out this wind. Makes it awkward. That caster's been. A small one though, but take them. Yeah, I'm done again now. No, we're not. I think this wind in my face is helping me catch, to be fair. Uncomfortable as it is, take the rough with the smooth. There we go. Oh dear, it's not good. Ooh. White hydroelastic, this is. Oh dear. Ooh. It's a carp, to be fair. If I look, that's what it was. Sometimes if a carp comes in, you swim, it can get rid of F1s and take a bit of time coming back. Perhaps you had that one in. come on here, have you? Decent size now. Heavy. Some baiting, took me a long time. They're still alright. Far too long for that fish. Small one, right in that. Yeah, all good. I think I'll go down edge again there, so I'm happy with that because it got a good run on them shallow. You never know. He's still feeding his shallow line, so. Before I were ready. Not the biggest fish, but welcome all the same. Yeah, perfect. Feels very heavy. To feed again. Come on here. Right, this ref wanted to be up a minute. It's a decent sized F1. It's from feeding, isn't it? Partner Matthew's doing well. How many had, Matt? How many had? Good lad. That's probably beating me. 27 pound, he's just said, is that not clear? But then again, his calculations aren't very good, Matthew, are they? Me talking then's probably affected the fish that spoke to me. Maybe not. Here. Sometimes I despair. Lady D. Oof. This is a good one.
But as it stands now, I'm on 75 fish. I've fed me 4 pints of casters. They're all gone. I want to go enough now for the hook. And I've started feeding 4 mils, fishery 4 mils. Wind's died down as well. So it's like they want the noise from the pellets. And so I want cast on the hook. Now I have been feeding my margin line, just on a top kit to my left here, down there. Well, I've done enough for a kilo of ground baiting the last 2 hours. But I've not seen any swales, it's only just over a foot deep. Oh, big swirl there, edge there. Now I'm torn. What do I do? Ooh. I'm catching on this. What do I do? I'm torn, torn. God, I'll have to try it. We'll keep feeding that top two on. Right, here we go. Let's try again. No swirling this time, so I've probably got what I'm going to get. Oh, that round tree. There we go. There's a big ghosty. They call it ghost because it used to be full of ghost carp. And F1s came along then. This is history. Can see it. Can see it. Then we're in the gap. Let's put some section on.
good.
Well, not very negative. Oh.
This could be an F1 list, to be fair.
Yep.
A decent sized F1. Bigger than what we're catching out there, so we'll take that.
Yes. The only F1, I'll take them.
I don't know. Big F1. A washing machine down here now.
Ghosty!
Tend to fight a lot better than all the other carp. Can't get them up.
Ghosty. Oh, that was ghosty, that. Took that. I'd have to put some.
We're on his run and then we'll get him out, back out. 20 minutes left and no point feeding shallow line now. Swirling like mad here. It's a shame you can't see it. They don't foul. Well, I hope it's not foul up because it swam into it. Waste my time. And this, let me fouled. Don't want it coming up at now.
Top banana.
Apart from that netting. A bit far out, I should have had it.
Grim in that. There we are. No mistake, second time. Two ghosties.
Girls.
Yeah. Yeah, Bren, if you'll come here, duck out. Oh, ducking net there, look, look at that. It's a bit weird. There you go. There we are. He's a good one. Now, run it. Looking like 34 dead to me.
34 dead. Right, yeah, 34 dead.
What'd you get them on, Grey?
Caster, top 2 and 2.
What, in the margin?
Corn and micros.
43. Well done, Greg.
Well done, Greg.
Just picked the other duck yet.
You got another one
there? 6 pound. Sorry, Uncle Steve.
31-1.
Cheers, my friend.
Mate.
Cheers, mate.
£182 dead.
Oh, thank you very much.
That's a good guy.
Right then, guys, match is finished. We've ended up with third has been Dean Adams with £106 on peg 8. Matt Wardle has comes second with £156 and he's been on peg 4, and 3 out of 3 for me on peg 17 with £182. I didn't think I got that much, to be fair. Set off shallow with a caster, top 2 and 2. Wind's been in my face, I found it really hard, but I've managed to persevere. Got that done, and then I fed my margin, just a top kit down my left-hand edge in about a foot of water, piece of corn, overwetted micros. I fed a kilo of ground bait all day potting up, and I was just waiting for a swirl. About 3:15 time, I saw a swirl, went down, and the keep net I put in, as you saw on the camera, the keep net I put in, I had £43 in the last 45 minutes. I thought Matt had beat me, because I thought his fish were bigger than mine, but luckily, it hasn't been the case, so I'm very happy with that. His next match will be on Lodge Farm on the Signal Lake very soon, and I'll be there to film that one as well. So hopefully you tune into that one, and I'll see you again. Thank you very much.